Hey, nice statue, right? I'm gonna tell you all about this. This is Fridtjof the Beautiful. But first, I had no idea so many people would like the previous video and that it would generate so much fuss. So thanks for that. It was only about DNA and people living in the Viking world. And I've seemed to gotten my first few haters. And I haven't experienced that much of it, but I see some comments from these haters. They're telling me you cannot be a Viking because the Vikings used to live 1,000 years ago. And I suspect this is some kind of woke ideology of sorts. And I'd like to address that. And I could, of course, invite you to a single hand-to-hand combat like the Vikings used to do to prove my point. Holmgang, we used to call it. But I'll try this instead. You seem to be somewhat confused mixing the Viking of the Viking world with the modern concept of being a Viking with the trademark Viking or the stereotype of being a Viking. And this is what so many of us Scandinavians meet whenever we are traveling. You know, you're supposed to drink beer and you're supposed to be able to fight. And there's all these expectations out of us, especially when we meet Irish people and Australians for some reason and Kiwis. And we got to live up to that stereotype, man. So don't tell me there's no such thing as a concept of a modern day Viking, because we meet it all the time. It's perhaps the most, if you take away all the trademarks in the world that are commercial, what are you left with? And Viking is pretty high up on that list, because I think everyone in the world gets some kind of weird pictures in their head when they hear the word Viking, right? That means it's spread a lot, and whatever those images can be or what feelings that can come out, that's another story, I guess. But there's a new podcast out today, which it's called the Nordic Mythology Podcast with two interesting guys. And I'm interviewed there, so I'll put the link down below right now. And we're talking a little bit about this. First, we're talking about for 45, 50 minutes about the Viking paper. But in the last half hour, if you skip to that, we're addressing this. How or what it means to have a Viking mentality today. So if you'd like to hear more about this, sure, press the link below and check it out. Maybe it's something, or comment down below and I'll try to reply as much as I can. Now, the story with Fridtjof here, the Fridtjof the Beautiful. First, it was the Kaiser Wilhelm II who put this up here. In 1913, because he was a lot on vacation here. Right here on the other side of the fjord, I'm going to show you now, is Barle Strand, and King Bale. He was his daughter was the one who was in love with Fridtjof over here, and out here in Barle, Kaiser Wilhelm was a lot in garden parties. He had a lot of fun here, I understand. There's a lot of stories. And it was also a famous tourist place for the first mountain climbers, especially the English ones who came over here and started going into the wonderful mountains over there. Now, this story about Fridtjof the Beautiful is from before the Viking Age, quite a bit before the Viking Age. And the reason why the Vikings kept the story and have delivered it to us today, so we can still read it, and please do. I think it's because it's a love story, and it's a story about coming from, he was a harse, which means he was not really high up on the hierarchy, but I mean, he couldn't marry a king's daughter, but they fell in love, you know, because they lived on right across the fjord of each other. And there are two brothers of the princess. They didn't like him at all, you know, but he proved them wrong. Oh, I'm not going to spoil it even. So please check it out. Maybe I'll put a link down below for that also. And if you have any comments, especially about being a Viking or being somewhat confused about being a Viking, please feel free to write down below. Take care.